So hey you guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new, welcome. I'm Gleens, and you guys, let me tell you, I had a whole plan for this whole week for videos that I'm going to post this week, but you guys, I was so excited, I was so excited to show you guys this video that I couldn't wait. So I was done with work. I thought, no, I'm going to make up. I'm going to get ready for do this intro for you guys because I'm so excited to show you this set. You guys, it came out so pretty that I couldn't wait. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I did these old English letters. It's like a 3D kinda old English lettering. It's pink, it's neon, it's summery, it's the thing, it's bomb. So yeah, you guys, but before you go on and watch this video, go on my Instagram and my TikTok, show me some love. I will put my name in the screen so you can see. And you guys, after you have showed me some love on Instagram and on TikTok, I have also Facebook, so go ahead, show me some love, follow me. I will put the link of my social medias in the description box below, and then come back and watch this video. Okay, so I have already prepped the nails, and if you didn't see how I do that, you can go ahead and watch my other videos so you can see and get to know me a little bit how I do that. And I'm applying the pink color. This is a pink color that I've mixed myself. I've just grabbed some neon pink and I've mixed it with some white acrylic powder because I wanted a light Barbie pink, so the old English letters can be more popping. You can see them better on the, like, the contrast of the colors can be more obvious. So that's why I decided to do a lighter pink, because in the first I really wanted to do the, like, the English letters the same color as the base of the nails, but then I thought maybe a lighter color will be making the English letters more obvious so you can see them better and the contrast will be nicer. So that's why I did that, and as you can see, I'm applying the pink on the whole entire nail, and after that I'm encapsulating the nail with some clear acrylic. Thank you.
So this is how the nails look after application. And next I'm using my medium grit bit to smooth down the nails and to also get the shape sharper. And I'm speeding up this part, you guys, because I don't want this video to be too long. And I feel like I do this in all my videos, and it's like, I don't know, let me know in the comments below if you guys like to watch me filing. But I'm speeding it up because I don't want the video to be too long for you guys. And yeah, that's why. But if you want me to slow down the process of filing, you can also let me know. Or maybe I will make a video for you guys on how to file the nails. I think I'm going to make a video on how to lay the acrylic, and also how to do that on the cuticle area and filing. What do you guys think? Maybe I can make a video of laying acrylic and a separate video of filing. I think I'm going to do that. Let me know in the comments below, and let me know your thoughts about these ideas. Next, I'm using my tapered bit to get into the cuticle area. I will put a link of my nail bits in the description box below. Well, actually, it's not even a link to the tapered bit, because on Cupa Ink from Mandy Pro, I've bought like a bit kit or something like so. I think there was like 10 bits. So I'll put a link of that in the description box below for you guys. And next, I'm using my hand file to perfect the shape. So am I the only one that thinks that this looks so satisfying? And now that was how the nails looked after filing, shaping and buffing the nails. And now I'm applying my Cakes Ink Nails Gel Top Coat on all the nails. And I'm curing it for 2 minutes under my lamp. Okay, so this is the exciting part. I'm using a gel bottle, the gel bottle, I don't know how this color is called, but I will put a link in the description box below for you guys. So what I did was, I just got a small little brush to draw down the English, old English lettering. I'm drawing a one on the pinky. If you think that this is too difficult for you, you can also get like a white marker or a white or a pencil, something that you can draw the design first before you're going to apply your gel polish. So that's like a guideline for you. So you can also do that, but I didn't do that. I just saw a picture on Google, and I've just painted the one or the symbols myself. I mean the letters, I'm sorry. I just draw the letters myself, and before curing it, you will get your, I've got my neon pink, and just, how do you say that? I'm so sorry, you guys. Mind you, my language is Dutch, so I also talk Dutch or Papiamento. Papiamento is from Curacao, so you guys, I'm so sorry, don't come for me, but sometimes I just don't come out of my words, because I have to think first in Papiamento, then in Dutch, and then in English. I'm sorry for that. But yes, like I was saying, first I'm drawing the letters with my gel polish, and before curing them, I sprinkle. Can I say sprinkle? I'm sprinkling some acrylic over the gel polish, you have to make sure they turn matte before you cure them. So when you sprinkle the acrylic the first time, you will see that the gel polish will soak the acrylic, and then you will continue sprinkling the acrylic until you see that the acrylic turned matte before you period in under your lamp. So otherwise it will stay tacky. So make sure your gel polish soak all the your gel polish soak first the acrylic, and after that you'll just keep sprinkling it with acrylic. So yeah, and then I'm flash curing it after each design so they won't move or I don't get on the design and to ruin my design. So that's why I'm flash curing the nails. Oh, and you guys, the acrylic that I'm using was from our line, the Spicy Pink from my summer collection. But as you guys know, I don't have my webshop anymore because it's currently unavailable and I'm expanding. I just want to have a big variety of colors for you guys, so that's why. And yeah, actually the light pink that I've mixed the Spicy Pink from our line with some white. So I just mix those two colors. So babe, if you're still here watching with me, I really want to thank you that you're still watching and making some nail designs with me. I really appreciate your company. Thank you so much for that. And if you're still here, just go ahead in the comment section below and comment a pink hearted emoji that I know, so I know that you're still here making some pretty old English letters with me. Just let me know in the comments below. I just love to read your guys' comments. It's always positive and I get sometimes great feedback that I also love. So yeah, you guys, thank you so much. And you, if you're not subscribed yet, go ahead and click on the subscribe button. It's for free. And you know, we are all a family. We are making some lit nail designs. So join us. It will be lit. Okay, you guys, so after I've cured all the nails and make sure all the nails were properly dry, I went in with the manicure brush and get the excess acrylic powder off, and I got a little brush, and I get into the cuticle area with some alcohol to get the excess acrylic off. And now I also wanted to show you one letter from the other hand. I'm painting the G on this finger, but I will show you when I'm done. I will show you the end result of both hands. I've drawn 1996 on one hand, on her, I think her right hand, and on her left side. I'm sorry, and on her left hand I've wrote P and G, that were her initials. I want to show you how I did also one of the letters, and on the pinky I'm going to draw one heart, one little heart. Thank you. Okay, you guys, I've cleaned both hands and this is how they look. Guys, I have to say, I'm so proud of myself. These came out so bomb on video. On camera, you can see how bomb they came out, but actually in person, wow. The colors, the two colors just went so good. I just love it. And here you can see the nails without any lighting. You guys, look at the neon pink. Pretty, pretty.
So yeah, you guys, this was the end of the video. Let me know in the comments below what you think of this set. Let me know in the comments below if you have any suggestions of me doing any videos or kind of videos you would like to see. And if you didn't subscribe yet but you like my video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Click on the subscribe button and also on the notification bell so you're the first one to know when I post the next time. If you've liked this video, give this video a big thumbs up. Share it with your family and friends, with everybody. Share it. Share this video. Oh, and if you didn't know, I post 3 times a week. I post on Wednesday, on Friday, and on Sunday. Okay? So come back. Please come back. I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye, guys.